Bebé, no sé si habla mucho español.
Bebé, no sé si habla mucho español. Bebé, no sé si habla mucho español. No sé means I don't know. No here turns into the negative not. Sé is the present form of the verb saber, which means to know. Sí, without an accent, means if, and it's used to establish conditions or doubts, as in when you're wondering something. For example, me pregunto si hoy lloverá. But remember that sí with an accent means yes or oneself, depending on the context. Like for example, se conoce a sí misma. Habla is a colloquial way of saying hablas, meaning you talk, since Spanish speakers tend to drop the S at the end of a verb when speaking colloquially. By saying no sé si habla mucho español, Rao is telling Selena he is wondering if she speaks much Spanish, being that it's her second language since she's Mexican-American.
Si entiende cuando digo mi amor.
Si entiende cuando digo mi amor. Si entiende cuando digo mi amor. Si entiende means if you understand. Entiende is the colloquial way of saying entiendes by dropping the S. It's the tú form of the verb entender, which means to understand. Cuando here means when. However, cuando without an accent can have other meanings. Cuando can mean as. For example, empezó a llover cuando salía de casa. Cuando can also mean while. For example, cuídate cuando no esté. So, altogether, si entiende cuando means if you understand when.
Comernos sin entender no es mejor.
Comernos sin entender no es mejor. Comernos sin entender no es mejor. Sin means without. Entenderno is another example of dropping the S at the end of a verb. It's the colloquial way of saying entendernos, which is a form of the verb entender, meaning to understand, like we saw before. Entendernos is conjugated in the first person plural nosotros, referring to Selena and Rao, which is why the English can be translated to understanding each other. E is yet another example of dropping the S. Here, E is a colloquial way of saying es, which is the present form of the verb ser, meaning to be. Mejor is an adjective meaning better. So, sin entender no es mejor means without understanding each other is better.
Solo tenemos que gustarnos.
Solo tenemos que gustarnos. Solo tenemos que gustarnos. Solo here means just or only, since it's being used as an adverb. The adverb solo is a shortened version of solamente, and Spanish speakers use it when we want to indicate that nothing else is included besides what is expressed. For example, solo me gusta el helado de chocolate. If solo were to be used as an adjective, it would mean alone. For example, me gusta estar solo. Tenemos means we have. Tenemos is the colloquial way of saying what? You guessed it, tenemos. You can kind of see a trend of dropping the S in this song. Tenemos is the nosotros form of the verb tener, which means to have. Que here means to. Tener que is a fixed expression which always means have to. For example, tenemos que pagar antes de irnos. Gustarnos o gustarnos means to like each other. By saying solo tenemos que gustarnos, Rao means that emotions transcend languages.
¿Quieres que caigan tentaciones?
¿Quieres que caiga en tentaciones? ¿Quieres que caiga en tentaciones? ¿Quieres means you want? Quieres comes from the verb querer, which can mean a lot of different things, including to love. For example, sé que me quieres. Querer can also mean to aspire to. For example, quiero ser rico de mayor. Que here means to again. The expression querer que is fixed and it always means want to. Caiga is a form of the verb caer, which typically means to fall, either literally or figuratively, like in this song. Caiga is in the subjunctive conjugation of the verb caer. This mood is used to express desires or wishes. For example, espero que no se caiga. And the preposition en means in or into. So, by saying, ¿quieres que caiga en tentaciones?, Selena is telling Raúl she knows he wants her to give in to her impulses.
Mira cómo me pone.
Mira cómo me pone. Mira cómo me pone. Cómo means how. In other contexts, cómo with an accent can also mean what. For example, no sé cómo es. Me is the first person singular possessive pronoun, which translates to me. Pone is, of course, a way of saying pones. Pone, in this context, means gets. The expression me pones is a non-literal use of the verb poner. In Spain, me pone would mean turns me on because of the context. However, in most other Spanish-speaking countries, the non-literal meaning of me pone almost always refers to a state or a situation someone put you through. For example, me pones nerviosa. In Spain, me pone can also have this meaning. It just depends on the context.
Ese acento que tienes.
Ese acento que tienes. Ese acento que tienes. Que here means that. However, it's omitted in the English version. Tienes means you have. Tienes comes from the verb tener, which means to have. This sentence is a very good example on how you don't usually include the subject in Spanish sentences, since it's already a part of the verb. For example, te quiero mucho. You can tell who the subject is because of the te and the conjugation of quiero. If, however, you said yo te quiero mucho, you would be placing emphasis on the fact that it's you who loves the other person a lot. Selena is saying that she loves Raúl Alejandro's Puerto Rican accent.
No entiendo mucho, pero vente.
No entiendo mucho, pero vente. No entiendo mucho, pero vente. Pero means but. This is the perfect time to remind you that when there's an R in between two vowels in the middle of a word, it's a soft R, like pero, cara, or lámpara. Vente means come here. Vente is a form of the verb venir, which means to come. It's conjugated in the second person singular, tú. In Spanish, you don't have to specify aquí, while in English, it sounds like something is missing from the sentence if you don't add the here. Vente, ¿has visto nuestro PDF gratis? Have you checked out our free PDF? It gives you easy access to all the vocabulary that we have learned today, so you can study it whenever. Get it by clicking on the link in the description below.
Baila, baila, baila conmigo.
Baila, baila, baila conmigo. Baila, baila, baila conmigo. Conmigo means with me. Conmigo is a combination of the preposition con and the pronoun me. So, altogether, conmigo means with me. Conmigo is the first person personal pronoun. You use a verb, in this case, baila, plus conmigo as a way to give a command to do something with me. For example, ven conmigo.
Baila, baila, que yo te sigo.
Baila, baila, que yo te sigo. Baila, baila, que yo te sigo. Que yo te sigo here means I'll follow. Que in this sentence translates to that, but in this case it can be omitted in English. Que yo te sigo. Yo means I. As we saw earlier, we don't usually specify subject in Spanish unless it's for emphasis, which is the case here, since Selena could say baila que te sigo. And you would be able to guess the subject of the sentence by the verb te sigo. Te is a personal pronoun which means you. You is omitted in English since Selena is not literally going to follow Raúl, but she's going to follow his lead when dancing. Sigo is a form of the verb seguir, to follow. Sigo here means will follow, despite the Spanish being in the present tense. This is because, in Spanish, we sometimes use the present tense to refer to future actions when speaking colloquially. You tell the difference by relying on context. Another example of a false future tense is hazlo que yo te ayudo.
Dance with the
Pégate, ven, suéltate. Pégate, ven, suéltate. Pégate here means stick to me. Pégate comes from the verb pegar, which can mean different things, depending on if it's being used literally or figuratively. If we look up pégate on an automatic translator, it'll tell us that it means stick, which is on the right track but isn't actually helpful, since pégate can mean different things depending on context. For example, pégate, ven, ven, pa casa, ven, ven. If we click on pégate on these interactive subtitles, we'll see that in this context, the pégate means come close or get close. It's being used similarly to how Raúl uses it. In this other video, however,
está este cubo en la pantalla, rebota todo el día y a veces se dirige justo a la esquina en el último minuto, pega y rebota.
If we click on pega, we can see that it means strike or hits. So in this context, the verb pegar means to hit instead of to come close. If you're wondering what this handy dandy tool is, it's FluentU, an app for learning Spanish with authentic videos, including movie scenes, clips from TV shows, TED Talks, and music videos. FluentU has thousands of videos, all of which have subtitles written by language experts, so you always see the correct definitions for words and expressions in that specific context, plus video examples of native speakers using the vocab. FluentU also creates personalized quizzes and speaking questions to make sure you remember everything you learn. Try it now for free. Just sign up for a 2-week trial using the link in the description below. Plus, FluentU is currently having a sale, so it's the perfect time to check it out. Going back to our line from before, suéltate is the imperative form of the verb soltar, which here means to loosen up. The verb soltar can mean a lot of things. If used literally, it means to release or to drop. For example, no me sueltes. If used figuratively, soltar can mean to let loose or to loosen up. Mis amigos me ayudan a soltarme. Here, Raúl is telling Selena to relax and just go with the flow.
No te me vayas sin las ganas de volver.
No te me vayas sin las ganas de volver. No te me vayas sin las ganas de volver. No te me vayas here means don't leave. No is the negative not. Te means you, which is usually omitted in English. Me means me, which can also be omitted in English. This use of me is extremely colloquial, so I wouldn't recommend using it at work. The sentence no te me vayas doesn't need a possessive pronoun, me. In fact, you could say no te vayas, and it would mean the same thing. However, sometimes you add the possessive pronoun me when speaking informally to make a conversation more personal and intimate. A similar thing in English might be adding on me, for example, no te me duermas. Adding me also implies that the action performed by someone else will also affect the speaker. So, no te me vayas could also be read as don't leave me. Vayas is a form of the verb ir, which means to leave or to go.
Bésame solo una vez.
Bésame solo una vez. Bésame solo una vez. Solo una vez means just once. We use this expression when we're describing something that only happened once or telling someone to only do something once. For example, hazlo pero solo una vez. Solo here means just, while una vez means once. Be careful, because the English once, una vez, and the Spanish once, 11, are false friends.
Así tengo un motivo pa volverte a ver.
Así tengo un motivo pa volverte a ver. Así tengo un motivo pa volverte a ver. Volverte a ver means see you again. Volverte comes from the verb volver, which means to return or to go back. The verb volver is always followed by a when it means to return. For example, volver a casa. The te at the end of the verb volver is the personal pronoun for tú, which tells us that Selena is talking directly to Raúl using the informal tú. Ver is the infinitive of the verb to see. Volverte a ver is a very common phrase when talking to friends or family, and it usually denotes the speaker misses the listener. For example, no puedo esperar a volverte a ver. Another expression that you could use to mean the same thing is verte de nuevo. For example, quiero verte de nuevo mañana. Volverte a ver can also be used as a normal time frame, no feelings attached. For example, te pagaré cuando te vuelva a ver.
Sinceramente, dejemos que esto fluya.
Sinceramente, dejemos que esto fluya. Sinceramente, dejemos que esto fluya. Dejemos means let's let. Dejemos is the colloquial way of saying dejemos, which is a form of the verb dejar, meaning to let or to allow. Dejemos is yet another example of dropping the S at the end of the verb. You've probably noticed that Raúl drops the S much more often than Selena. That's because Raúl is Puerto Rican, where it's much more common to drop the S at the end of the verb than in Mexico or other Spanish-speaking regions. So, if you want to sound like a true native, just drop the S at the end of a verb. In very informal settings, of course.
No sigas dándole mente.
No sigas dándole mente. No sigas dándole mente. No sigas dándole mente means don't keep thinking about it. Sigas is a form of the verb seguir, which when used literally means to follow, or when used figuratively means to continue or to keep. Spanish speakers use no sigas to ask someone to stop doing something. For example, no sigas hablando, por favor. Dándole mente is an expression that means to think about. Dándole is a form of the verb dar, which means to give. Mente means mind, so dándole mente literally means giving mind, but it actually means to think about or to reflect on. Another example is no para de darle mente. By saying no sigas dándole mente, Raúl is asking her to stop overthinking things and just go with her gut. No sigas dándole mente. Suscríbete al canal. Click on the subscribe button so you won't miss any of our upcoming videos, like Learn Spanish with Friends, Monica Dates Jean-Claude Van Damme.
Tenemos toda la noche pa' que me enseñes de frente.
Tenemos toda la noche pa' que me enseñes de frente. Tenemos toda la noche pa' que me enseñes de frente. De frente means up front. De means off. Frente means front, when used as an adverb, or forehead, when used as a noun. For example, está en frente de la casa. Versus, tiene una frente muy grande. De frente is a fixed expression that means up front, head on, or straight ahead.
Todo lo que siente.
Todo lo que siente. Todo lo que siente. Siente or sientes here means you feel. Sientes is a form of the verb sentir, which means to feel. It's conjugated in the second person singular tú, since Raúl is talking directly to Selena. Raúl is saying that they have all night to unravel everything Selena is thinking and feeling.
Me huele a que no tiene nada de inocente.
Me huele a que no tiene nada de inocente. Me huele a que no tiene nada de inocente. Me huele a que means I get the feeling. The pronoun me again refers to me, which in some cases can be translated to I. Huele is a form of the verb oler, which means to smell. However, oler can be used in a figurative way to mean to get the feeling that, or if it's in the negative, to not feel good about. For example, esto no me huele nada bien. Que is once again translated to that, which is omitted in this sentence. When oler is used figuratively, like in this sentence, it is always followed by a que.
¿Cómo te digo que no quiero hablar de amor?
¿Cómo te digo que no quiero hablar de amor? ¿Cómo te digo que no quiero hablar de amor? ¿Cómo te digo que? Means how do I tell you. ¿Cómo here means how. Te means you. Digo means tell. Digo is a form of the verb decir, which means to say or to tell. Que once again means that, and once again, it's omitted in the English version. ¿Cómo te digo qué? Is a commonly used phrase, not only in romantic situations, but when you don't know how to express something or tell someone how you really feel. For example, ¿cómo le digo que le quiero? Que si contigo tengo que pensar mejor. Que si contigo tengo que pensar mejor. Que si means that if. Que means that. Si, without an accent, like in this line, is used to express a condition or a hypothesis, and it means if. In Spanish, you don't usually start a sentence with que si. In a more formal setting, you would simply start with si. However, Selena is continuing her train of thought from her previous line. So, ¿cómo te digo qué? Could also be considered the beginning of this sentence. ¿Cómo te digo que si contigo tengo que pensar mejor? Tranqui, déjalo así, quiero quedarme aquí. Tranqui, déjalo así, quiero quedarme aquí. Tranqui, déjalo así, quiero quedarme aquí. Tranqui means relax. Tranqui is a shortened, informal version of tranquilo or tranquila. Tranquilo comes from the verb tranquilizar, which means to relax. In this line, tranquilo is being used as an interjection, in which case it can mean take it easy, relax, calm down, or simply chill. Tranquilo is also an adjective which means calm or peaceful. It's very common for Spanish speakers to tell their friends or family tranqui when they think they're overreacting and don't actually need to worry. For example, tranqui tío, no te preocupes. Pégate, ven a mí, pégate, ven a mí. Pégate, ven a mí, pégate, ven a mí. Pégate, ven a mí, pégate, ven a mí. Ven a mí means come to me. Ven is the imperative form of the verb venir, which means to come. The imperative is used to order or to command someone to do something. In this case, come. Another example of the imperative ven is ven aquí ahora mismo. A here means to. Mi means me. Here, Rao is telling Selena to go over to him and to stick close to him. In this next video, Selena sings about how she feels after leaving her ex. So go watch that video to find out how she came out of that relationship stronger than ever and enjoy more Selena Gomez goodness as you learn more conversational Spanish.